The United States is sending over $3 billion to Israel's military in the middle of the pandemic, while Americans are struggling to survive, waiting in massive lines for food banks, and begging for stimulus relief money. Our government continues to support the genocidal apartheid project known as Israel. Another 6 million Americans fell into extreme poverty over recent months. That $3 billion that we just sent to the Israeli military could have given those impoverished Americans another $600 stimulus check. It's absolutely ridiculous that there is arguing and debates by Congress whether we should or can afford to put money in the pockets of desperate Americans when we continuously throw exorbitant amounts of money at imperial projects of aggression around the globe. Israel gets more than half of America's foreign defense aid. It's not like they can try to defend this as humanitarian assistance money to support health projects or hospitals in Israel. This is strictly for the Israeli military, for advanced weapons and armaments. Our government's drive to finish the ethnic cleansing of Palestine is clear. But is there any hope for a change of direction with the new presidential administration coming in? Absolutely not. The $3 billion being sent to Israel right now originates from a commitment orchestrated by the Obama administration. That's when the Democrats had power and Joe Biden was vice president. We promised $3.8 billion for 10 years to boost the Israeli military, which is occupying and ethnically cleansing Palestine to create a Jewish ethno-state. The Democratic Party and the Biden-Harris executive duo are staunch supporters of Israel. I'll let them tell you in their own words.
America's commitment to Israel is absolutely unshakable. It is unquestionable.
And we must stand with Israel, which is why I support the United States' commitment to provide Israel with $38 billion in military assistance over the next decade. I am fully committing to maintaining Israel's qualitative military edge.
Thank you for watching. Please share this video and subscribe to If America's New for the latest news and analysis.